Why CAPTCHA? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. We've all seen them. We've all been frustrated by them. Click on all the images that contain a bicycle, or a bridge, or stairs, or click on this slider and move it to the right until the image is properly aligned, or pick the two things shown in different orientations that are the same thing. Those are all CAPTCHAs, which is an acronym for Completely Automated Public Turing Test to Tell Computers and Humans Apart. It's even trademarked by Carnegie Mellon University. As frustrating as they are, they exist for a very important reason. And I'm sad to say you're likely to see them more often. As with so many things these days, it all starts with spam and spammers. There are several scenarios in which CAPTCHAs stem the tide of spam. Without CAPTCHA, it's easy to use a computer program to open thousands of free email accounts and start sending spam from them. Sure, the accounts would eventually be blocked, but the program just keeps on creating thousands more. Without CAPTCHA, it's easy to use a computer program to leave thousands of spammy comments on Ask Leo and other blogs and websites. It's easy to overwhelm just about any website that has an input form that even looks like it might be a comment submission form. Spammers have incurred untold millions of dollars in additional cost and burden on website owners and internet users. CAPTCHAs are one way to keep that from growing out of control. One of the oldest challenges in computer science is to build a computer or software that mimics thinking like a human, and it does it so well that you can't tell the difference. Asked a series of questions, you wouldn't be able to tell whether the responses came from a real human or a computer. That's referred to as a Turing test, named after computer scientist Alan Turing. You've probably heard more about it of late with the rise of AI. Many AIs can pass various forms of Turing tests. More on that in a second. A CAPTCHA is a kind of Turing test. It's a test to prove you're human. Now, until recently, the old-style distorted letter style of CAPTCHA stymied computer programs. And then this happened. I didn't even tell ChatGPT what to do. I just pasted in the image that I used in a previous version of the article that this is based on, an example of what was once impossible for computers to decipher. And it simply deciphered it. Yikes, right? And I'll bet you haven't seen that style of CAPTCHA for some time. Even the ones we do see, distorted image identification and matching, are slowly becoming things that current AIs can figure out. The result, of course, is an arms race. You can expect to see more and different forms of CAPTCHAs in the future. Now, CAPTCHAs have one huge drawback. For the most part, they assume you can see. Blind computer users, of whom there are many, cannot complete a visually oriented CAPTCHAs. As a result, there are alternatives. Some use images. Click on all the pictures with a tree. Or even simple math expressed as a sentence. What do you get when you add 2 and 7? The goal is the same. Answering these types of tests is surprisingly difficult to automate, so a correct result is reasonably possible only if you're human. Another alternative, many text-based CAPTCHAs play an audio that sight-impaired videos can listen to and then type in. Of late, an even simpler CAPTCHA has become very popular, the Click Here CAPTCHA. As simple as this seems, it's apparently fairly effective. The trick, if you will, is that you can't click the checkbox right away. It's actually replaced by a spinning disk until it's ready for your input. Current automated spam bots aren't capable of something as simple as detecting that a delay is required. Some also employ other behind-the-scenes tricks, such as monitoring mouse movement while they wait, to determine whether or not the entity at the keyboard is a human or not. Many CAPTCHA techniques now rely on behavioral analysis rather than on your ability to identify bicycles in a grid. Now, I take comments, but I don't currently use CAPTCHA. How's that possible, after all? Well, I pay for a service that attempts to block spam. For example, in the article that goes along with this video, I show a current spam count that 381 blocked comment spam attempts had happened at the time I was working on that article so far that day. It'll easily cross 600 attempts pretty much by the end of every day. We're looking at something like 250,000 attempts to post spam comments on Ask Leo every year. Because spammers aggressively and constantly change their approach, I'm not ruling out requiring a CAPTCHA sometime in the future, but for now, things seem to work well. Except, of course, things are getting worse. A few days ago, one of my servers, unfortunately not the one housing AskLeo itself, bogged down to a crawl and finally crashed. The culprit? Bots and scrapers. Specifically, a new genre of spiders that are scraping websites for content to feed AI large language models. There are so many, and they are so persistent and overwhelming, they can bring websites to their knees. Not to mention copying all the content. As a result, many websites are now throwing up a CAPTCHA before you can even view their content. It's no longer only about spam, but about protecting the servers and the content the websites present. In my case, I just beefed up the server specs a little bit and all seems to be well, for now. I'm not as concerned about content theft, as some see it, as I am about just keeping my servers online. CAPTCHA's future will continue to be interesting. AI can already automatically decipher many of today's CAPTCHA images and techniques. Look for new approaches, hopefully still easy for humans to use, to prevent further automated abuse in the future. But the bottom line, don't blame the website for using a CAPTCHA. It's a corner that they've been forced into. Blame the spammers and scrapers and bots. For updates, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/2695. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.